सो हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू दिस वीडियो सीरीज़ ऑफ सब्जेक्ट मोबाइल एप्लीकेशन डेवलपमेंट। सो टुडे वी विल कवर द लास्ट टॉपिक ऑफ दिस यूनिट, वेरी वेरी लेंथी यूनिट, दैट इज़ यूनिट नंबर 5, एक्टिविटी एंड मल्टीमीडिया विथ डेटाबेसेस। सो द लास्ट एंड द इम्पोर्टेंट टॉपिक ऑफ दिस यूनिट इज टू परफॉर्म द कनेक्टिविटी विथ SQLite डेटाबेस, दैट इज कनेक्टिंग अवर एंड्रॉयड एप्लीकेशन विथ द डेटाबेस दैट इज अवर SQLite। SQLite इज बाय डिफॉल्ट प्रोवाइडेड बाय द एंड्रॉयड platform to perform the connectivity or to store the data of our Android application. So the course outcome of this unit is to create Android application with database. So mainly this course outcome properly matches with our the current topic, that is connectivity with SQLite. SQLite is a light version database in which we can perform the SQL manipulations that are related to perform inside a database, that is insert, update, delete, and it is a light version, that is it is used basically for lighter versions of mobile devices, like mobile devices or any other tablets likewise. So the learning outcome of this video is to study the SQLite connected. SQLite is a database name, okay? So SQLite connectivity with the our Android application. So how we will study how to connect the SQLite database with our Android application and perform the different DML operations inside. Different DML operation means insert, update, delete. Likewise, we can perform different operations. So the POs mapped are PO1, PO4, PO6 and PO7. So coming to SQLite database in Android. So SQLite is an open source. So the main reason for using this SQLite database is it is an open source relational database. Relational database means we can perform the DML operations and perform the queries, inner queries, subqueries like operations inside it. That is, it is used to perform database operations on Android devices, such as storing, storage of data is there, manipulation means that DML part, that is insert, update, delete, or retrieve. Main is the retrieval. The retrieve means to select the data and get it inside our mobile device. It is embedded in Android by default. So as I have said earlier, it is embedded in the Android by default. So it is present in the Android operating system as a default. So there is no need to perform any database setup or administrative tasks. So the main class here is SQLite Open Helper class. It provides the functionality to use our SQLite database present inside our Android system. SQLite database class. So there is a open helper class as well as database class. It contains methods to be performed on SQLite database. So majorly we will use this SQLite database class. Open helper class will provide all the functionality which is present inside the SQLite database class. So normally 90% of times we use SQLite database class, in which we can perform all the major operations on the database, such as create, update, delete, all CRUD related operation. CRUD means create, read, update, delete operations can be performed on this SQLite database with the help of SQLite database class. So the different methods present inside the SQL, we have to study that before, because if we want to use that class, we should know the different methods present inside the class. So we have taken the first method as void execute SQL, in bracket there is a parameter or argument, that is string SQL. String SQL means the type is of string and the SQL statement. So it will execute SQL means it will execute the SQL query. Execution means it will perform different operation, and selection means it will select the records. So we don't have to select, we have to execute the query. in case when we have to perform insert, update or delete operations, we will use this method, that is void execute SQL. Inside that argument we have as an argument we have to give the SQL query. What will be the SQL query? Insert into table, likewise will be the, or delete from table. So this will be our SQL query. So that SQL query we will first store inside a string, and that string will be passed as an argument to this method. So this is the first method. Second is the insert method. So in the insert method we have to give the arguments as table, that is table name, column hack stands for the column count, number of column inside the table, and the content values means the column headers. So it will insert the record into the database along with the table name. So basically this method we will use only once whenever we are creating a table inside our database. Similarly, there is update, same content, string table, content values, string clause, that is string, it updates a row, and cursor, as you all know, in the database it returns the current transaction instance of a particular DML statement. So it will return a cursor over the result set. So these are the different methods we will use. So we will consider a simple example about how to insert the data inside our SQLite database. So first we have created a simple class named as contact. Inside that we have created some variables like ID, name, phone number. Then we have used the constructor. Why constructor is used? It is used for initialization of our member variables. So they should not be null, therefore we use the constructor. So public contact is nothing but the constructor. And then we have again made a parameterized constructor, that is public contact. In that we have given as integer ID, string name, whatever the member variables we have taken, and then assign that arguments or parameters to our member variable, that is this dot ID means the current instance of ID in the particular class, that is integer ID that we have specified. So ID will be equals to ID, name will be equals to name which we have passed inside the parameter, and phone number will be equals to the phone number which we have passed inside the parameter of the contact method. So again we have created one method which is a public contact. So in this case we are overloading the constructor. We are using different types of constructor. In the first constructor is the default constructor, second is a parameterized constructor, and third is also a parameterized constructor, but in that constructor we have provided only the name and the phone number. In the first constructor we have given the default values. In the second we have provided the ID, phone number and name. In the third one we have given only name and phone number. So this is the simple class which you all know how to create. So next we have created a method called as getID. getID will get the ID. It is similar to get and set method which is used in the Java. Get and set. Get will get the value and set will set the value to the particular instance variable. Similarly for name and phone number we have done the same task. So by this way we have created a Java class to initialize the DML transaction inside our database. So nothing we have given, this is a simple class called as contact, in which we have defined three variables, that is ID, name and phone number, and we have initialized them, and then we have get the particular member variable instance and set the value to the particular member variable instance. Next, that is next class we have defined as a base class or a master class, we can say. So in this class we will extend our SQLite open class or SQLite database class. So the class name is database handler. So whatever the static variables we have defined in this class, there is no such need for defining such static variables, because we have separately defined a class name as contact. So in that case we don't have to define these private static variables. So you can skip these steps. And next, the main method is to create the table. So on create, that is on create, and the argument is SQLite database DB. This will come by default whenever we initialize, when we initialize or extend a particular class with the help of SQLite open helper. So on create, what should happen? We are creating a table, that is create table. Table contents are ID, that is primitive, data type text, that is key name is text, key phone number is text, and then we are executing, that is creating the table with the help of db.execute sql, and create contacts table. Create contact tables mean this is the name of the table which we have just created. So we have used the first method, that is execute sql. What this sql execute sql is doing, it is creating a table. How we are creating the table? Inside a string variable we have given the query as create contact table, create, and the name is contact tables. So likewise we can create our table. Next is we have to insert the record into the SQLite database. So we have used the object of SQLite database, that is DB. Class name is SQLite database is equals to this dot get writable database. Get writable means we have to write or insert inside the. So this is the default method which is provided by the SQLite database class. Writable, in case of selection we will have to use the readable database method, get readable database. In case of insertion or creation of new record, we are writing the record into the database. Therefore the method name is get writable database. Inside the database, therefore there is a database part. Content values. Content values means the column header values equals to new content values. So values are key name, that is contact get key name, then values dot put. Put is used to set the values. So we are setting it as name. No need to give the ID here because the ID will be automatically generated by the SQLite database. So we are giving name, that is get name method, and get phone number, and insert our row with the help of db.insert. Our database object is db and we are using the insert method. Inside that we are given the table contents, that is table name, and null. Why we have given this as null? Second argument, because if we specify any value in this, the table will by default contain that value. We want to get the values which the user has supplied to it. So if we don't specify null, it will return the default values given by our system, and then set the new values as values. And then in the last step we are closing our database. So in this way we can perform the insert operation. Simple insert we have performed, nothing complex coding we have done. Just use the ready-made methods which are provided by the SQLite database class. So important MSBT related questions are how to perform the SQLite database connectivity with our Android application. So we have learned today about how to connect our Android application with the SQLite database, along with that how to perform some DML operations using that particular SQLite connectivity. So thanks for watching this video lecture. From the next video, we will start our 6th unit and try to complete it as fast as possible.